Boom to the hey, all you sports fans, or to you, the individual fan out there in the tubosphere. Welcome to the One Man Sports Rant, Gen 3.0. I am your host, Split Finger, Bruce Sooner, fastball throwing, a.k.a. Will, the alternative ESPN sports role. Doing my best, I'm Danny, a.k.a. the Count. Don't know who I'm talking about? Where the heck you been, brother? Best reality show yet on history. Counts customs, counting cars. Don't know what I mean? Roll clips.
We're going to California and we're bringing this car to Ziggy. We're about 5 days from leaving. This car has to be there.
Yeah.
This car is literally representing Bob. Can you believe that? That we've been entrusted with representing Bob Marley with his last car. So, we don't have a choice. We've cleaned out the tank twice. We've cleaned out the lines. We are going to literally have to just turn the key and roll the dice. This is Vegas. It's time to gamble. Let's fire this car up and run it. Well, this is it. We're out of time. Even if we could find a new European gas tank for this car, there's no way in the world that we could get it in the car, installed, up and running before we make our deadline. Ain't gonna happen. I gotta trust that my guys have cleaned this gas tank out to absolute perfection so that when we fire this baby up, she runs smooth. Because if not, that means we have failed. And on a job this big, this important, failure, it's just not an option, man. This is Bob Marley's Mercedes.
All right, so now you see, you know, kind of how he rolls, how I roll. Us car guys, good people. All right, so you're seeing vestiges of 4.0. Sorry. Which is fitting that we're doing, you know, fourth go-round of college football once it starts up this year. I'm not going to talk too much at the beginning. It's called the DMCA, Digital Millennium Copyright Act. I know this show's not everybody's cup of tea. It's not my first choice to have to do it like this, but it's a necessary evil. This was so much easier 3 years ago. All right, you see from our Pi Kappa Alpha House Sweethearts, U of U chapter, Alpha Tau, giving you props. All right, so this is the baseline show. You want to come back and see any other part, you'll know where you are based on the title. Just fast forward through all this. Baseball tonight with he who some call Tim doing week 11 in review. Part 3, very cool. Check it out if you're not watching part 3 right now. Mariano Rivera, you gotta root for that guy. Even I became a Yankee fan just because of his pitching when they won, what, two in a row or three in a row every other year back in the mid to late 90s type deal. All right. There is the sound effect. I'm transporting out of here. Roll game clips.
Are you that can summon up fire without flint or tinder?
I am an enchanter.
By what name are you known?
There are some who call me Tim.
Greetings, Tim. In baseball history, 1917, Ernie Shore, 9 hitless innings in relief to Babe Ruth, was ejected after one batter. 1971, Rick Wise pitched a no-hitter and hit 2 home runs. And in 2012, Jim Thome hit his 13th walk-off homer of his career. It's the most of all time passing Stan Musial. In spring training 1994, then Yankees manager Buck Showalter was watching Mariano Rivera work out on a back field. He was coming off a major injury. They weren't sure if he was going to be a starter or a closer, and he had a really stiff wrist, so he couldn't really throw a curveball. And Buck remembers thinking, this guy has a great arm, but what are we going to do with this guy? And then Rivera developed the cutter and went on to become the greatest closer of all time. Here's Tom Rinaldi.
Best stories in sports. This is the E60 feature presentation. April 4th, 2013.
Got it! Ball game. Yankees win 4-2, and Mariano picks up his first save of his final season.
For Mariano Rivera, this was his first save in 11 months, and the one he most doubted would ever happen. Why? The answer lies not on a mound, but on a warning track. May 3rd, 2012, in Kansas City, as Rivera shagged flies during batting practice.
I remember going for a ball. I tried to move. The leg was stuck. All of a sudden, I'm on the floor. Yes, I grabbed my leg. I can't even scream at the guys.
Why couldn't you scream?
Nothing came out. It was so much pain that nothing came out.
Doctors confirmed what Rivera feared. His right ACL was completely torn. His season and perhaps his career were over.
I stopped thinking for a minute, and then everything hit after that. And I said, wow, you know, the whole year. And then the next day, I said, I was thinking to leave the game, but I can't leave like this.
At his best, when it matters most, Mariano Rivera has become the game's right-handed conclusion and its ultimate clutch performer.
Broke it back, no surprise.
In 141 career postseason innings, he's allowed 11 earned runs, an ERA of 0.70. His 42 postseason saves, the most in history. Rivera, who owns 5 championship rings, is the only man to get the last out of the World Series 4 different times.
Ball game over! World Series over! Yankees win!
What makes Rivera's success more astounding, hitters have known what he is throwing and still can't hit. The same grip and the same pitch over and over again.
How did you discover, first, just say it. Go ahead. Just say the cutter for me. Just go ahead and say it.
Cutter? The cutter.
Rivera first threw the cut fastball, the pitch that stamped his greatness, in a bullpen in 1997. Not by plan, but by accident.
He starts throwing his fastball, and all of a sudden, he throws one with action, with late cut. Threw another one the same way. Now I'm looking at him like, what are you doing?
Since that day, the ball hasn't stopped moving.
Over 19 seasons, pitching for the game's most famous franchise, playing in the biggest city, Rivera has somehow remained largely free of celebrity or entourage.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Ma'am, how are you tonight?
I'm good, but who are you?
My name is Mariano Rivera.
The best relief pitcher in baseball.
Great. Good for you.
But this is a place where nearly everyone knows who Mariano Rivera is. Panama. Vibrant and proud. Bright and humble. Less than an hour from Panama City, on the Pacific side of the country, is the tiny fishing village of Puerto Caimito, Mariano Rivera's hometown.
As you stand here, and you think of the boy that played on white sands, to the man who gets the final outs in World Series, how do you describe that journey?
Amazing, it's unbelievable. I still can't understand how that happened. Yes, I have a little abilities, but you know, they were far more better players than me.
At 19, he was spotted by a Yankee scout and given a tryout. At 20, he was signed. behind and would soon leave Panama without speaking a word of English to find his way and make his place in the game. In Rivera's first appearance in New York in 1995, he gave up 7 runs as a starting pitcher.
High and deep to center field.
16 years later, on September 19th, 2011, he etched an all-time milestone, 602 saves and counting.
Ball game over, Yankees win, and it's perfect because the greatest closer in history now has the most saves in history.
The one thing Rivera was unable to control is the one thing all athletes face eventually, the passage of time. Mariano Rivera faced the inevitable on March the 9th. At 43 years old, fully recovered from his knee injury, he announced once and for all the 2013 season would be his last.
It's not too easy when you come to a decision like this. I almost collapsed there. I almost started crying there. And I had to talk about me. I don't like that. But seeing my team out there and have my family, my wife, my kids with me, that was huge for me.
What did your family tell you?
My wife, she said, well, I want you to be home. But if you want to continue, I support you. We support you. Oh. One more year, though. One more year.
So this year, he tries to do the same thing he's always done, knowing this will be the last time he does it. Mariano Rivera leaves the pen, takes the mound, gets the sign, and throws the pitch. It's his end, in his hands.
What feeling will you miss most?
It's a feeling to open the doors from the bullpen and hear your fans going crazy if we are home. And then if we family, knowing myself, it's a great feeling.
If you do this for me, selfishly, one last time, say the words.
That caught her. That's wonderful.
Mariano Rivera has more saves than the next two active closers combined. Another of a million great notes about Mariano Rivera. Jason, you've covered this game your whole life. What are we looking at here?
Dan, we're looking at something special. I have kind of a fun little Mariano moment from this.
He made the Yankees more likable,
In the Yankees clubhouse, it's like 9 o'clock in the morning, and they come through and they say, hey, Mariano's going to be facing hitters. Little sim game at 9:15. So I got to go out and walk into the dugout at Legends Field, Steinbrenner Field, and climb up to the top step and lean against the rail and watch this guy run in from the bullpen the way he always has and do that little thing right there and throw to hitters for the first time since he hurt himself. And I have to admit, it gave me chills, man. I started thinking about Buck Showalter and Joe Torre, Joe Girardi, leaning against the rail in that dugout, watching this guy and all the great players who stood there and watched him. And you know what, Tim? I'm not a fan of any team, but I am a fan of greatness. And I know when I see it, especially from 100 feet away at 9:15 in the morning.
Absolutely. I get chills thinking about that. Buster, nobody knows Mariano Rivera better than you do. What's your takeaway on him, his career, the whole thing?
I got a great story about his cutter. In 1997, when he discovered it, playing catch with teammate Ramiro Mendoza, the ball was moving so much that initially the Yankees were concerned. In fact, there were bullpen sessions. This is what the bullpen catcher Mike Borzella told me, in which they actually were working to eliminate that movement on the cutter. And eventually Rivera, at such great command, decided, you know what, I'm going to try to work with this. Yesterday I spoke with Joe Nathan, who is the second all-time leading saves leader among active pitchers and has about half of what Rivera has as in saves. He told me that the first time that he spoke with Rivera, he asked him, of course, how do you throw that cutter? And he said after he explained it, he realized nobody else can throw it that way. That's what separates him. Nathan thinks of Rivera as baseball royalty.
Well, he is.